The Boy Who Cried Wolf. Here's a story old Mr. Aesop told of a little boy named Streaky, who tended sheep atop a tall mountain. Not a bad little boy, but certainly a very foolish one. He had heard about a wicked old wolf who used to steal sheep and drive them back in the hills where no one could ever find them. Streaky's best friend was a big, strong, jolly blacksmith who always had time to stop his work and talk to him.
With hammer and anvil I work all day. My forge is never cold. Oh, it's work for some and some for clay. My work is fun, I'm told.
One day, little Streaky was watching his sheep and playing on his flute when he saw someone coming toward him.
I love mutton and I love beef. My appetite's beyond belief. A good fat sheep is a meal for me. I'm as greedy a wolf as you ever did see.
He was a strange-looking person, dressed in a big hat pulled down over his eyes, and he wore a long coat that came all the way down to his heels. He had a long, hairy nose, and, though Streaky couldn't see it, underneath that coat was a long, bushy tail that could only belong to a wolf. The stranger came closer and closer and finally said,
"Hello, little boy. Where did you get those delicious, those beautiful sheep?"
"They belong to my father, and I watch them so the wolf won't get them. Did you come to play with me?"
"Well, maybe. What can we do?"
"I can play the flute for you. Listen."
"Nah, that's no fun. Let's play a joke on someone so we can laugh. Why don't you run down this long hill and tell Petrov the blacksmith the wolf is here?"
"But the wolf isn't here."
"No, that's the joke. Petrov runs all the way up here and no wolf."
"Oh, I see. Won't that be a joke on him? You wait here."
"I'll wait right behind this bush."
The wolf, my sheep, he's come to kill. Oh, Pedro, pray, chase him, wait, come on, run up the hill.
Petrov, the jolly blacksmith, heard Streaky calling and, picking up a big stick, ran as hard as he could up the long hill to the pasture. It wasn't easy running up that steep hill. When he got there, he looked around and said,
"Where is he, Streaky? Where is that wolf? I fix him."
"Oh, Petrov, the joke's on you. Huh? There isn't any wolf."
"A joke? Oh, ha, ha! You play joke on old Petrov, Streaky, you little rascal. I get back to work now."
And as Petrov, the jolly blacksmith, plodded down the hill, Streaky looked around for his new friend and found him hiding behind a bush.
"Oh, there you are. Wasn't that fun? Did you see Petrov run up the hill?"
"Yeah. He looked funny, huffing and puffing after that run."
"But why did you hide behind the bush?"
"Oh, I always hide behind the bush."
"Well, what shall we do now?"
"Oh, let's do it again."
"Again?"
"Yeah, again."
"All right." The wolf, my sheep, he's come to kill. Oh, Petrov, pray, chase him away. Come on, run up the hill.
"Where is he, Streaky? Where is that wolf? I fix him."
"Oh, Petrov, the joke's on you again. There isn't any wolf."
"So you fooled Petrov a second time, you funny little fella, Streaky. Someday I play joke on you, too."
"That was a good joke. I'm so glad you came to play with me. What shall we do now?"
"Well, it's getting kind of late. Guess I'll have to take your sheep and go along now."
"You'll have to... You know what I thought you said? I thought you said you were going to take my sheep." "I thought for a minute you were the wolf."
"I am the wolf."
"What? You're the wolf? Oh!" Oh,
Hello, Streaky, you funny fellow.
The wolf, he's taking my sheep.
You think you fooled Petrov again, huh?
No, I mean it. The wolf is here.
Oh, Streaky.
Please believe me, Petrov. He's really here. Stop laughing and come with me.
You like to see Petrov run up that hill, don't you, Streaky? Tomorrow, maybe, I do it for you again.
He's really, really, really here.
Then invite him down to watch me work, Streaky.
No matter how hard Streaky tried, he couldn't make Petrov believe that the wolf was actually there. You're right, he lost every one of his sheep. Now Streaky always says, never cry wolf just to try a good friend, for the wolf may appear. And that is the end. ¶¶